Thank you, Brian. I'd also like to thank CRW for offering this time this evening to talk a little bit about the history of the organization. And also thank Melanie Morris, who's videotaping the event today. She's also a member of CRW.
CRW got started, like, how is it you all formed together during
during that time. We didn't have any internet then. How did you all get together during that time? And what kind of, information hubs were there? How did you meet each other? And then how did you get the CRW started? It is very simple that Ben Olden, who ran the bicycle exchange, was the hub of our meetings. And somehow Ralph Taylor and Ben and I was just buying, I had just bought bicycles for my three kids and discovered that bicycles had gears, and not like my Elgin bicycle newspaper days in high school. And I said, I saw the gears stretched, the cable stretched, and I was advised that the owner was advised that he was going to have to make adjustments. And I said, well, I better get acquainted with this. And so I went for a ride and said, I have one of these things. And so I got one of those things secondhand in Raleigh Sports for $50 from the lady in Quincy. And I started to get up early in the morning so I could go for a ride around Louisville. And it occurred to me as I was laboring around Louisville one morning, there's no need to do this, I could ride to work. So taking the key, which was easy from where I lived in Melbourne. And so that's how I started to commute. And the commercial part of my bicycling life certainly had most of the hilarious events, and not so hilarious. But the Charles River Wheelmen started in Ben Elkin's shop somehow, coalesced around Ben Elkin, and I was lucky enough to hear about it, and Brother George was, and four other guys. And so it was in an awful rainy September Sunday afternoon, 50 years ago, we met in the eaves of the old Ashland Railroad Station, and that was where the CRW started. And I see it's still the Charles River Wheelmen. They haven't succumbed to natural pressures that the Native American bicyclists did. We used to be Native American Wheelmen for those who didn't know. But that changed. And I don't know what that is. Has there been pressure from the Charles River people? I've never heard of any movement.
That's the name of their newsletter now. It's the Wheel People.
Ah, I'm out of touch. So, and there were lots of people that I discovered at MIT where I was working, and everywhere I went, there were bicycles parked, and not securely. So that became a natural project for me and David Gordon Wilson to work on for getting civilized parking arrangements at MIT. So the Wheelmen got started with, before we were organized, we had several century rides. We started Ralph Gaines' dental office in Mount Auburn, on Mount Auburn Street, just outside of Harvard Square. And we would head off west and off 117 County and so forth, out to Leominster, and went through the Leominster State Forest and managed to get 3 miles or so. And by the time we had the first ride was a century ride. Around with it, Ralph Gillens, and then we weren't very serious about our commission. Ended that century ride at Ralph's with a cocktail party. Sounds would be unheard of these days, would it not? Well, anyway, so that was the start of it, and I
know this is Western, but runs to the, it's got some trunks, double centuries for the cycle maps of Springfield. They were headed by the Moreno Redmaker and his family, Larson. And I walked on that went for a ride that Larry mentioned on the Nova Scotia tour in 69. That's where the cycle maps came in touch with Charles River Wheelmen.
Well, one of the early writers
Eddie was not a professional. He was from the Deptford, and I can't remember his name.
James.
But he liked to wear later hosen. Some of them were embarrassing, but the more serious writers and the more messy. But he was not actually among the eight of the staff, but he was one of the early writers. So they were out, they weren't all engineers, lawyers, heads, other better type. And they certainly were not working. And it's nothing. I have no explanation for that.
Or maybe the next 50th year anniversary, we'll talk about that. Questions from the audience? Who'd like to ask a question? Yes, way in the back.
How did the club begin to grow? How did it expand?
The question is, how did the club begin to grow? How did it expand during your first years of it?
It really had everything to do with Van Alken's bicycle exchange, because any riders who came into Ben's place, he'd put them in touch with us and send them to Ralph Young and our neighbors. That was how CRW started, really.
Other questions? The question is, when did women first join?
If you know. Out that even by 1970, a third of the advisors and members for women.
Woo!
And if you look at the membership today, a third of the riders are women. The difference is that in 1970, close to a third of the membership, in fact, a little more than a third of the membership was from either Boston or Cambridge. And that's down to about 12% now. As CRW has moved out into the suburban areas now more and more. So it's been a big change. So let me see if there's one or two more questions, and then we're going to turn it over to Ken to do some awards. More questions? Yes?
How many rides a year did you do? Ride every week?
How many rides a year did you do? Did you ride every week or what?
Well, we pretty much put things aside in the wintertime. We really might say a pickup ride from anyone who wanted to go up or freeze.
That's true.
Those were not century rides. But otherwise, starting in the springtime, we probably had at least 2 centuries a month.
Wow.
So can you tell us a little bit about that ride up Mount Washington? That you were involved with a couple of other famous members of the CRW.
So Ralph, the indomitable Ralph Galen, I was really the one who wanted to do it, and I thought it sounded like a nice idea. So I was designated to lead this first annual Charles River Wheelmen ride up Mount Washington. And so Ralph and I and another rider who, another member of the original group,
thank you, Bruce.